Hey guys, I just did another video and someone asked me a question about pet peeves, or pet hates as we call them in England. And it made me think. I have a few of them, and some of them are silly, some of them are not, you can decide. So I thought, why not make a video about them, explain myself. So just to start off, let's go straight in. The first thing that really irritates me is cash points. Generally, I mentioned this in the last video. It's not the cash points themselves as much as it is the people that use them. When you're in a queue for a cash point, I always seem to get the person in front of me that has to do everything on the cash point. They don't just get money in, put their card in and get money out like cash points are supposed to be for. They have like three cards, have to check all their accounts, one of them doesn't have money in, then they top up their phone, then they get an on-screen balance, then they get a printed balance, and then like by the end of it, I've been standing there for ages and just wondering why. Why are you doing all this at a cash point in a street? You can check your balance at home on the internet, you know what I mean? Like, that, I just don't understand it. Surely, when you're in a public place and you're trying to get money out, which is a bit of a sensitive subject anyway, you just want to get straight in there and do it, not do everything else, especially while other people are waiting. So, don't know if any of you share that, but that's the first one. The next one is quite a common one, but this has two sides to it. Traffic. I really hate sitting in traffic when I'm in a car, because I guess one of my things is I hate being powerless. I hate not being able to control my own destiny, not being able to do anything about something. And when you're sitting in traffic, there's nothing you can do. There's literally like, that's it. Like, you're just waiting there, being frustrated. And often whenever we're driving somewhere, we have somewhere that we have to be that's quite important. So that's like another angle to the stress. And then relating to that as well, another pet peeve related to traffic is the kind of people that when they're in traffic, they think beeping or blowing their horn is helping. They think that beeping is gonna, suddenly everyone in front of them is gonna go, all right mate, sorry, oh actually I didn't notice you were there, I'll get out of the way. All the traffic's gonna part and they're just gonna be able to sail on. Or, you know, they I don't know what fucking planet they're on. What are they thinking? That they're gonna like, just the sea is going to part, the force of the horn is gonna blow the cars out of the way? I don't know. Beeping is gonna make God realise that this traffic is gonna need to move. He wakes up, oh right, okay, oh sorry about that, I'll sort it out. I don't know, so that's two levels. So it's one, I don't like being inconvenienced in a traffic jam, and two, there's idiots around you going, ugh. So yeah, beeping and traffic. Next, and this is probably my biggest one, is people being late. Sometimes it happens, I get it. Sometimes transport's late, tube's late, something happens and you can't be there on time. It happens to me, but at that point you text someone, it's the modern age, there's about a million ways you can get in touch with them. Or call them if you actually want to speak to them and say, sorry, I'm going to be a bit late. And they go, okay, that's fine. What I really hate is when people are late and they're arrogant enough to assume that they're more important than you. They don't have to tell you that they're going to be late. They're arrogant enough to assume that the person whose time that they're wasting at the other end doesn't matter. And that's what it says to me, because if you're late and you're telling someone you're late, that person's waiting around. Happens to me a lot because I try and be on time. So I'm waiting there, waiting for whoever this person is, insert person A, just thinking, I wonder what makes them think they're important enough to waste my time. So that's it. It's not just being late. I think the extension of being late is the fact that you think that you're better than the person that you're making, that you're inconveniencing, because why else would you do that? You obviously don't care. So yeah, if you're gonna be late, just text me and I'll be all right with it. I'll go, okay, cool, that shit happens, fine. But yeah, so being late, I'm probably gonna have a brain aneurysm by the end of this video, because this stuff is just, just gets me. Another one that we get a lot of deliveries, and I hate couriers, nearly all of them. So, or any delivery people, you have the single easiest job in the world. It's simple. You take something from one place and you bring it to another. If they're not in, you leave a card. I could do it tomorrow. However, 9 out of 10 of my deliveries somehow don't manage to make it here. And miraculously, I don't have a letter. If I do, it has some kind of scribble on it. I've just kind of gone, chucked it through the letterbox. I mean, we rehearse here at Shane's house, and because we know that we're going to be in the rehearsal room, and we're not going to hear the doorbell, we leave a note on the door. And the note says, quite obviously, we can't hear you, we're in the rehearsal room, here's a number, call. So they just go up to the door, completely ignore the note, put a note through saying, oh, I couldn't find you when we were over there, and then they don't deliver it. So I'm sure you've had the same experience. How do they get it so wrong? How do they get it so wrong? Just bring it. And then the ones that say, when you call them up, where's my package? And they go, oh yeah, they buzzed the doorbell and left a note. No, you didn't. I've been all day. I've been in all day and you didn't do anything. So yeah, couriers, why? Just sort it out. And this is a pretty serious one. I really hate it when every man, I don't know about you ladies, but we'll have a hierarchy of boxer shorts. And we'll have you'll have your best boxers, and then you'll have your second best boxers. And then you'll have your, bottom of the pile boxers that you don't really like getting out unless you have to. Sometimes if I've been busy, I start working down to the bottom of the pile boxers, and if I misjudge and I get the wrong pair, it's just game over for me that day. It's really bad. Like, the ones that are kind of coming in and they don't have enough tension around the legs, or they're just a bit short and they kind of ride up into your crotch and it makes you feel like you're wearing Y fronts, which is just not good. I need a little bit of room to breathe. So that's definitely a pet hate. When I've misjudged my boxer situation, I have to wear bottom of the pile boxers and it just has me uncomfortable all day. It's no good. No good. So yeah, there's a few of them. I probably have a load more. I was just trying to think of a select few, like the winners, as it were, top of the pile. But comment under the video with your pet peeves. I want to hear. We all have them. Sometimes they make sense, sometimes they don't. But it's all okay. It's fine to have them. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.